Hi guys, welcome to Friday First Chapter Read Aloud. We are going to be reading from Rex Ogle's book, Free Lunch, where he talks about his own experiences growing up and going to middle school and being one of those kids who couldn't afford to buy his own lunch. And so he had to get in the free and reduced lunch line, and everybody would see him get into the line and then make fun of him. And so he decided not to eat, which created more problems for him. He has a great biography where he's talking about his experiences on YouTube. I'll link that below the video. But this is Free Lunch by Rex Ogle. The dedication says, "This book is for every kid, whether they pay for their lunch or not." My stomach growls. This morning I skipped breakfast, though not because I want to. When Mom steers our two-door Toyota hatchback into a parking space in front of Kroger, I mumble, "I hate grocery shopping." "Well, how else are we going to eat?" Mom asks. "Eat what? You never get anything I like." "When you get a job and start paying for the groceries yourself, you can buy whatever you want." "I can't get a job. I'm a kid." "Sounds like your problem, not mine." When Liam goes to the store with his mom, she lets him get anything he wants. Pop-Tarts, toaster strudel, Twix bars, Pringles, whatever. That's because Liam is a spoiled brat and his mom is rich. They aren't rich just because they live in a house. "Well, they're richer than us," Mom shouts. She gets out of the car and slams the door. I don't take off my seatbelt. Mom storms around the car and tries to open the door. It takes a second because it has a big dent in the side that catches every time. Metal wrenches against metal when she jerks it open. "Get out of the car! Can I get just one thing I want?" Not budging, I stare straight ahead, my arms crossed like a shield. I don't know why I get so angry about this stuff. This is how it's been my whole life. But some days I hate my life and I feel like fighting. Fighting my mom, fighting other kids, fighting the world. Doesn't matter. Just something to take the sting out of me being so broke. "I'm going to count to three," Mom growls through gritted teeth. I see her fingers curl into her palms, making fists. "One." "Fine," I shout back. I get out of the car and slam the broken door, the metal catching like robot nails on a chalkboard. Usually I stand my ground, but Mom gets that red look in her eyes. I know it's better to stop arguing. I pull a shopping cart from the pen. One of the wheels is wonky and spins left and right instead of rolling straight. I consider putting it back, getting a new one, but then I feel bad for it. It's not the car's fault it's messed up. We make our way down one aisle and then another. My mouth is watering. There's aisles full of food. Peanut butter, pasta, stuff to make tacos or burgers, all kinds of cereal, practically a thousand kinds of chips and dips and salsas, then cookies, Chex Mix, beef jerky, fried mozzarella sticks, waffles, Granny Smith apples, pies, donuts, dozens of different flavors of ice cream. And I can't get any of it. I know better than to ask for anything. Mom's answer is always no, or no way, or are you crazy? Put it back. It's too expensive. It's crazy to say a bag of potato chips is too expensive. A whole bag costs like $4. That seems like a lot of money, but it can be 10 little meals. That's only like 40 cents each. Now my stomach is really growling and grumbling. I try to ignore it as I push the empty cart behind Mom. This morning, we only had enough Cheerios and milk for like half a person. I got up first and could have eaten it. I didn't though. I saved them for Ford. He's my baby brother, and he's only two, so he needs it more. Mom shoves an open envelope into my hand. Inside is an overdue bill. I ask, "What's this for?" "On the back, stupid," she says. On the back is a grocery list. Mom's tall, loopy cursive handwriting is hard to read, but it says all the stuff we need. Milk, cereal, bread, that kind of junk. My mom usually sticks to the list, but some days she changes her mind based on the yellow signs for today's specials or clearance items. "Look, this ground beef is on sale for $1, she says. The meat is all weird brown, though. I scrunch my face. Raw beef's supposed to be pink. Mom rolls her eyes, throwing it in the cart. "It's still good. Just cook it well done." Turning from one aisle to the next, I see the lady with free samples. I leave the cart behind to run over. With a smile, she says, Would you like to try maplewood sausage? I grab a toothpick-stabbed mini bite, dip it in the mustard, and shove the whole thing in my mouth. I savor the juicy explosion of flavor, but it's gone too soon. Before the lady can object, I take two more. I make sure to smile and say, "Thank you." "Mom, free samples," I point. "It's so good. Can we buy some?" Mom ignores me. Too busy digging through her folder of coupons, she spends all day, Sunday, every Sunday, cutting coupons out of the newspaper. Then she makes sure we only go grocery shopping on Tuesdays. Tuesdays are double coupon day. "Yes," Mom says in victory, "this coupon is for $2 off. Double, that means $4 in savings." "Since you're saving $4, can we get a box of mac and cheese?" "No, but it's Ford's favorite. He's a toddler, he doesn't have a favorite anything." When we're around the next corner, there's another sample person. This guy has cheese and crackers, but there's no sign that says free. Trying to be polite, I ask, "Are these free?" He gives me a dirty look. "If you're gonna buy some." "Hey," my mom shouts, "I don't see a sign saying anything about buying nothing. Rex, go ahead, have as many as you want." I feel my face redden. I'm hungry, but I don't want to be rude. I take the smallest cracker with a little square of cheese on it, and I whisper, "Thank you." "Don't thank him," Mom snaps at me, glaring at him. "He thinks he's so much better than us, but he's the one selling cheese." The man mutters under his breath, "Trailer trash." "We don't live in a trailer anymore," Mom shouts at him. "So there." She takes control of the cart and pushes us away. I'm relieved. For a second, I thought she was going to pick a fight. It wouldn't be the first time. My mom doesn't shy away from much, especially confrontation. As we move toward the checkout a few minutes later, Mom is still agitated, talking to herself like a crazy person, looking down on us. She doesn't even know me. Doesn't even know my situation. Thinks he's so much better than us. At the register, I transfer the items from the cart onto the conveyor belt. The cashier watches me as I look at the candy racks. Cashiers always look at me like they're watching to see if I'll steal something. Like I'm guilty because my clothes are from a secondhand store. While the cashier rings up stuff, Mom pulls out her wallet. She's counting money, except the money looks different from usual. I've never seen it before. It looks like toy money, like from that game Monopoly. It's all bright and colored and says food coupon. "What's that?" I ask. "Don't worry about it," Mom snaps. She pushes me toward the end of the counter. "Don't just stand there being lazy. Bag the groceries." The cashier finishes scanning, then does the discount for the coupons. She says the total. Mom hands her the weird, fake-looking money. The cashier punches some buttons and says, "After the food stamps, you owe $10.38. "What are food stamps?" I ask. "Don't worry about it," Mom repeats, but this time she scowls at me. Stamps are for the post office, so I wonder if my mom is going to mail our food home, but that doesn't make any sense. We drove here so we can drive the groceries home like normal. Mom pours all the cash and change out of her wallet. She unwrinkles $8 bills, then counts out 98.7 cents, mostly in pennies. Her hands tense up, her fingers looking like talons. She says, "I'm a little short." The cashier shrugs, but really she's all annoyed. I can see it in her face. The woman behind us with a full cart throws her arms up and goes, "What is taking so long?" The man in line next to us clears his throat. It feels like everyone is staring at us, frustrated. Mom's face is strained, a vein popping out on her forehead. Suddenly, she seems embarrassed. I feel embarrassed, too. Mom snatches the loaf of bread from the top of the brown bag. She shoves it toward the cashier. "There, take that off. Happy?" Shopping is always like this, but for some reason, this time is worse. Maybe because of the food stamps? Mom looks ashamed. People are staring. Then I look at our shopping list. We didn't even get halfway down. We can't afford all our groceries. Silence hangs between Mom and me. I carry the one bag to the car and put it in the back. When I get into the front seat, Mom starts crying. I'm not sure what to say, so I don't say anything. We sit there for a long time. When I reach out to put my hand over her hand, she slaps it away. "Don't touch me. This is your fault. Do you know how expensive it is to raise an ungrateful brat?" I feel sick to my stomach. I don't know if it's because I'm angry or sad or just hungry. Probably it's all three. Ministers and priests and Buddhist monks and talk show hosts, all those people who are supposed to be real, smart, and wise and stuff, always say dumb things like, "Money isn't everything," or, "The best things in life are free," but they're wrong. Money is everything. The best things in life aren't free. And don't say something stupid like, love is free, because it's not. It costs money to take care of people you love. When mom isn't working, she's always upset and sad, and she can't love me like a normal mom. She gets mad at every little thing. No job means no money, which means no groceries or electricity. That makes all the love go out of my mom like air out of a balloon. And who wants an empty balloon? When mom's working, she's nicer. She definitely loves me more when she has money, because she can afford groceries and pay rent on time, bills too, all that junk. She can think straight. She remembers she cares about me. So don't tell me love is free, because I know nothing in this world is free. Every little thing costs something. But for some reason, things cost a whole lot more when you're poor. That's Free Lunch by Rex Ogle, part of our Project Lit book set this year. Check it out at the library.